Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts. Let him return to the Lord, and he will have mercy on him, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. Isaiah 55, 6, 7. He will abundantly pardon. For you have to seek the pardon. You have to seek the pardon. And if you seek the pardon, he will forgive. The Lord is near to those who have a broken heart, and save as such as have a contrite spirit. Psalm 34, verse 18. That everyone may turn from his evil way, that I may forgive their sin. That everyone may leave their evil way, and I will forgive their sin. But we have to leave the evil way. We have to leave the evil way. And then he says, I will forgive their sin. But we have to leave the evil way. I acknowledge my sin to you and my iniquity, says the psalmist. He says, I acknowledge my sin and my iniquity. But do you acknowledge your sin? Do you acknowledge your iniquity? I will confess my transgression to the Lord. Will you do that today? Will you confess your transgressions to the Lord today? Will you confess your transgressions to the Lord and say, Lord, I have transgressed. I have sinned against you, O God. And you forgave the iniquity of my sin. And you forgave the iniquity of my sin. You forgave the iniquity of my sin. He was forgiven because he confessed. He was forgiven because he confessed. Will you confess today your sin? Will you confess whatever you've done wrong? Will you confess it to the Lord? And if you confess, he will pardon you and he will forgive you. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. He says if we confess our sins. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. God promises us that if we go to him, he promises that if we turn to him, and that if we confess, that he will forgive us, that he will cleanse us. Repent, therefore, and be converted that your sins may be blotted out. There is a command to repent. God commands that we repent. He says, repent of the lies. He says, repent of the stealing. He says, repent of the swearing. He says, repent of the adultery. He says, repent. Repent, therefore, and be converted. We have to repent. We have to be sorry for the things that we have done wrong. We have to repent. And God commands us to repent of that which we know is wrong. And so he says, repent, therefore, and be converted. We have to be converted. Converted means that our hearts are born again, that our hearts are forgiven by the cross, that our hearts are cleansed at the cross, that our hearts are washed at the cross, that we have the forgiveness at the cross, the mercy at the cross. I will hear what God the Lord will speak. He will speak peace to his people and to his saints. But let them turn back fully. Let them turn back fully. There is peace. There is peace in your life if you turn back to God fully. There is peace and forgiveness if you turn back to God fully. But you have to turn back fully. You have to forsake the things that are evil. You have to forsake that which is evil, that which is wicked. You have to forsake it, and when you forsake it, there is peace. There is peace with the Lord. And the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. And the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He was led as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before the shearers is silent, so he opened not his mouth. Isaiah 49:6. He was a sheep led to the slaughter. He was a lamb led to the slaughter. He was a lamb led to the slaughter for you on that cross. When he died on that cross, he was a lamb led to the slaughter for you. Not with the blood of goats and calves, but with his own blood, he entered the most holy place once and for all, having obtained eternal redemption. But now, once at the end of the age, he has appeared to put away sin by the sacrifice of himself. So Christ was offered once to bear the sins of men. That Christ was offered once to bear the sins of many. That he was offered once to bear the sins of many. That when he died on that cross, he was bearing your sin and my sin. That everything that you did wrong and everything that I did wrong, put him on that cross. He died on that cross for everything that you did wrong and everything that I did wrong. He died on that cross in your place and my place, and showed how much he loved us. God demonstrates his own love to us, that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
He died for me, what? What else did he die for?
He died on the cross.
He died for us.
How are you doing, John?
Good. I'm just... Look, you're in Black Hebrews.
Yeah?
What the cult.
You read only the Hebrew, Black Hebrew, that he died for.
Yeah?
But in reality, it's not very good. You look at it, all the white, you explain the back, they're going to be...
Amos 9:12.
What's all the options?
Amos, it's kind of puppet.
Amos 9,
yeah.
Verse 12.
That they may possess the dominion of Eden and of all the heathen which are called by thy name. The other day will I raise my top of the
name. In verse 11 it talks about basically giving the Edomites land.
What?
The Hebrews.
I'm talking about that Edomite being called by the Edomites.